How do we create a dynamic month range bar chart with conditional formatting? Say this is our actual data, this is our budget, and this is our based on budget, this is the achievement, and this is the conditional formatting. Say if it is achievement is more than equals 100%, then it is green. Achievement between 90 to 100%, it is yellow, and less than 90%, this is red. And here we have the month range. Say if we choose from the beginning is July, and if our end month is say June, so we have 12 months bar here, 12 months data here, and based on the conditional formatting, this is the red, yellow, and green. So how could we create this dynamic month range bar chart with conditional formatting? Let's go to a new workbook. So this is our new workbook. I just take the criteria first here, and based on the achievement criteria, this is our conditional formatting color, and this is our just month actual data and budget data. Now first we calculate our actual achievement, actual divided by budget. So this is our budget achievement in all the months. Now we calculate the data red, yellow, and green column based on the conditional conditions of achievement. First of all, red, if achievement less than 90%, then actual figure in the red column, otherwise NA. So here we have only red figure for the month of April because 83% achievement. In the yellow, there is two conditions, if and achievement less than 100%, and second condition, achievement greater than equals 90%, then we get actual data in the yellow column, otherwise NA. Third calculation, if achievement greater than equals 100%, then we get actual data in the green column, otherwise NA. So here we have the actual data spread in three columns based on the percentage of achievement. Now we calculate the max outline, maximum outline of the bar. So there is the max of this actual and this budget figure. We take plus 500 to give space in the bar. Now our data is ready. Now we plot the data in the bar. So select the month, this red, yellow, green, budget, and max outline. Go to the insert, take 2D clustered column bar chart. Now we just format the color of the bar. So first of all, red in the month of April, so we take, this is the red one, take as shape fill and take as red color. Yellow, so yellow we have in the month of July, so this is the yellow. Go to the shape fill and take yellow. And green, so in the month of September we have the green, select the green and take as this green color. Now again choose the budget bar, budget column, right click, go to the format data series, go to the fill and line, take fill as no fill, take border, solid border, and take this as this dark color, and take width as 2 point. Again choose the max outline, fill, no fill, border take as solid, and take color as white, and take width same as 2 point. Now again click the bar, right click, format data series, take series overlap as 100% and take gap width as also 100%, and just remove this grid line. Also for the timing, we just remove the chart title and also the this max outline. So our first part of chart is ready. So we prepared the chart based on the conditional formatting. Now we give the feature of the dynamic month range in this chart. So here we need certain calculations. First of all, we need our month, starting month from a drop down list. Go to the data validation, take as list and source as this month range. So our first month is July. Now copy this cell to paste cell here, and we choose our destination month, say December. Now we need calculations to choose month dynamically from this list. So we need a index match function. Index our array is this month range match. So we want to match the beginning month, and our lookup array is this month range. So we need exact match. So we need same thing for our destination month. Again, index array is this month range match destination month, and lookup array same this month range, and we need exact match. So our value is here, but you cannot see because multiple result in the same cell, that's why it keeps in this format. Now we want to keep this function formula paste for all red, yellow, green, budget and max line. So here our same function, but we need to change our, so our index array here is red. So here we just change this column as, say this is the column cell E. So we need change B to E. So we take our data from this column, and our month, this is the July. These add functions are same because we take month from this lookup array, but our index array is this red column. For this same function, we change this here. Now this is for red, and again we just copy this function for the yellow. Here we just click, we just move this index array to yellow, copy again, paste for all other column, or just change it. So from yellow, our index array to yellow to green. For budget, our index array is budget column. And for value max outline, our index array is max outline column. Other month lookup array is same for all the column. Now we create name range to give effect dynamically, dynamic way to the our chart. So here say this, we say this is our date, this is a red, this is yellow, this is green, this is budget, and this is max. So we select this formula, copy, go to the formula name range and click new. So the name of the name range is date, so this they take automatically here, and copy paste this formula here. Now you can match that. You see our calculation is okay. We choose July to December, they take July to December. Close. Now create name range for all other columns. So this is red, name range new, so that automatically this name here. And so click here, we see our formula is okay, they change this range. Again take the yellow name range new, so they take automatically this name, otherwise you need to give the name. Check it, formula is okay, they take this month range. Again for the green name range new, this is the green, they take automatically, and click okay. So this is our area, so our formula is okay. For the budget name range new, this is the, for the name is the budget, paste. So our calculation is okay. Again for the finally for the max. So our calculation is okay. Now we give this name range in the series so that they take the month dynamic way. So right click here, select data. First of all, we give the name range or our selection for the red. So select the red, go to the edit. So our series is red, it is okay. And series value, we give the our name range for the red. So first of all, we need to give the sheet name here. So write sheet 1. So as like we link the other sheet, so get the name range list, press F3, and here we get the name range list, select red. So again for the yellow, edit. So series is yellow, remove this, give the sheet name first, sheet 1, this is the sheet 1, and this as like we link the other sheet, so this is the same format, press F3 to get the name range list. So here our name range is for the yellow, choose yellow, okay. For the green one, edit, so take the series name as green, it is okay. Take, remove this, first of all write the sheet name and press F3, green. For the budget, edit, so this is the series name, it is okay. And for the series values, first of all write the sheet name, press F3 to get the name range list. So here it is for budget, okay. So choose the budget here. Finally, the max outline, edit. So series name is max outline, series value is, first of all write the sheet name and press F3 and choose the max. Now so for the value, our give the name range to our chart. Now finally give the date. So here first of all write the sheet name, sheet 1, and press F3, choose the date, press OK. Hope our name range placed properly. Now our real check, if we choose our destination date as June, yes it is changed dynamically, dynamic way. If it is March, this is March. If it is November, it is November. Hope you enjoy the video. Thank you for watching.